Hello, and welcome to the Cowboy Way. Opponents of video game violence disagree with the graphic nature presented in the videos. Now we'll go to some students here at AHS and see what their opinions are on these video games that have violence.
Hey, what's up? I think it's cool, man, like when they have blood and all, but Tekken they don't, Mortal Kombat they do, so that's cool, man. When you play it, it's alright. I think you like it.
I think it's sweet! WCW World Tour.
I think it's cool!
I think that... Am I supposed to talk in this? I think that it's okay if people have violence in their video games because there are the people who choose whether or not to rent them. And if they're going to let violence affect them, then that's fine. You know, they made the choice whether to rent the video game or not. You know?
I really don't think it's okay, because I don't think that little kids should be exposed to that kind of violence, especially in a video game.
I think video game violence is kind of bad on all video games, but yet it's alright because the video games wouldn't be any fun.
I think violence in video games is good because it makes them more fun, and a lot of people like it, and if you don't like it, then hey, don't play the games.
I don't think that it should have much of an effect on people because I think people should be smart enough to distinguish between what's fake and what's real life. And if they're stupid enough to like go out and do this stuff that they see on Mortal Kombat, they should be locked up.
Hi, my name's Jenna, and I'm opposed to video violence because I think it's a really bad example on all the little kids, because if they're just going to sit at home and they're going to watch people get beat up, instead of they can be doing very obviously stimulating things like playing with Barbies or watching Teletubbies. And that's all. Keep on running.
We're here with three members of the girls' basketball team, and how do you feel about the season overall?
I think it was a success from last year. We improved so much. We only won one last year. We won four this year. It was a big success. Although we didn't win, we played a lot of competitive teams and did a lot better against those teams than we did last year.
So do you feel overall you've had a building year mostly?
Yeah, next year they should be really good. Like Kaylee said, our teams were really competitive this year, and we played a lot of hard teams, a lot of state-ranked teams. And our win-loss record may not show how good we got, but we were overall a lot more successful this year than last year.
Could you tell us about senior night on February 5th and your first league win?
Yeah, it was our first league win in like 2 years or it was the last game of our senior year at Abilene High School. It was against Concordia, and I had 17 points, and it was really exciting and sad to say goodbye to the high school playing basketball. Yeah.
This is Elaine Schneider, and she's also a member of the girls' basketball team. And how do you feel about this year?
I feel like it's gone pretty well. We've won a lot more games than we have, not a lot, but we've won more games than last year, so it's going a lot better, and we're improving every day.
So do you have more confidence in upcoming seasons?
Oh, yeah, definitely. We've been playing together with the same girls for 2 years. We haven't really lost anybody, so we're, like, improving each day, and so we're going to be just as better next year, so because we've all played together for so long.
Black hole. Thanks. Sun. Won't you come?
This is Mr. Johnson, and he's the band instructor. And how do you feel about the band?
How do I feel about the band? Right now, things are going really well. We're getting ready, geared up to do contest, which is about a month and a half away. We've got several people that are preparing solos. Several of them are in the room right now. We also have a big event happening today. Chris Barlow is headed down to Wichita. We're just getting ready to leave here in about 2 minutes, actually, to play in the state honor band in Wichita. The concert will be on Saturday, so everybody should wish him luck. And, boy, right now, that's just about all we got going, but they're awfully big things. Thank you.
So, Lane, how's this band season going?
Band's going pretty well so far. I think we have a good sound. We're playing pretty good, and we're just getting ready for contests now, working on our concert band stuff.
What's something that you guys are trying to accomplish as a team this year?
We hope to have a good score at contests and play to the full our full potential, play the best that we can.
How have you been playing?
Personally, I think pretty good. I think I've been getting better. I don't know. Probably the best I have so far. So okay, I guess.
We're here with Mike Boyer. So Mike, if you could pay attention.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, how have you been enjoying band this year?
Oh, it's real fun. See, we do a lot of fun things in band. Playing and all that good stuff with the warm-ups.
What's something that you want to accomplish this year?
We want to do good at contests. We want to get ones so we can do good.
I don't know what else to ask. Make a wave the flag. Pull the red, white, and blue. And when the band plays, hail to the chief. Here we are at Country Mart, and I guess I'm going to interview the produce guy, Austin. How are you, Austin?
Fine.
Okay. Are you having a good day?
Yes, I am.
So, when you do produce, what do you do here? Like, what are you doing now?
Right now, I'm stocking the onions up.
And just that, what do you go? What's the process that you do that?
Just take them out of the box one by one.
Okay. Could you show us that real quick?
Awesome.
Are you supposed to throw them like that?
It doesn't matter with onions.
Do they bruise?
No.
What kind of fruits bruise like that?
Basically all the fruit that's like apples, oranges, and pears and all that stuff will bruise.
So you can't throw those?
No.
What if you did?
They'd have bruise spots on it, and they'd have to take them off and throw them away.
But the onions don't bruise?
No, they don't.
Okay, that's good. This is Devin, and he is a former employee of Country Mart, is that right?
Yep.
Why did you quit?
I got a better job.
A better job?
Paid better.
So there's no hidden agenda? No.
Nope, none.
Can you make one up for us?
The communists made me do it.
That's it?
Well, they paid me a lot of money, so.
Oh. Did they give you your new job?
Yes.
We're here in the meat department with
Robert Siebert.
Okay. And you cut meat and things like that, right?
Yeah, we cut meat for the whole case and do all the lunch meat case and the frozen meat case.
What's the largest piece of meat you've cut?
Probably the whole round at somewhere around 80 to 90 pounds.
That's of a cow?
Well, it's off the beef, yes.
Okay. What's the strangest animal you do here?
The what?
The strangest animal.
Well, we really don't do any strange animals. We have done probably be the buffalo, I imagine.
Oh, okay, I see. But nothing, just nothing small like rabbits and things like that.
We don't do anything small like that.
Okay, thanks for that. Here we are with Chris West, son of manager Steve West, and you work up there, right?
Yes.
What do you think about the employees up there?
Oh, they're good, hard workers.
You think so?
Yeah.
You haven't seen this tape, though.
I guess when I see it, I'll find out.
Yeah. Do you think you get special privileges because you work?
No.
You don't think so?
No, not at all.
But you get a check.
That's right, I do.
But none of the guys get a check.
What do you mean they don't get a check?
Like, I don't see
Anyone check
it? Oh, yeah. Well, they trust me with money, I guess.
Is that a special privilege?
No.
We're uncovering things.
What?
No. For the show.
What you did?
Can we ask you where the pimentos are?
Pimentos. I just started here.
I'm not sure. It'll be over on, like, aisle 4.
Oh. Could you help us find those?
What do we do?
We're looking for pimentos. Pimentos.
Fair, because I just started.
There's pimentos. Yep. These are sliced. What are pimentos exactly? Do you know?
Size. I have no idea.
So you don't know how they grow these or anything?
Nope.
What they're made out of?
No, it tells you some of the ingredients there, but that's about all.
What are the ingredients?
I don't see a label, do you?
I'm not seeing them.
I'm not either.
Oh, here it is. Pimentos are the main ingredient.
Pimento is like a hot pepper or something.
Okay, thanks. Here we are in the break room at Country Mart, and it's pretty comfy back here, and we're here with Jamie Clements, and what do you think about the break room?
Well, it's kind of small, but I wish it was a little bigger. Other than that, it's pretty nice.
You don't like the smoking.
Oh, you don't like it?
I don't like being in here when people smoke, because then you get invested with all that smoke, and your eyes burns. It's bad.
And clothes smell.
In the summer, doesn't the smoke help keep the flies out?
No, man, they keep coming because people buy food back here, so then we have to buy those little things, and there's like dead flies stuck to it, but it's fine.
Hello again, and we're going to go find out where this goes, right here, but we're going to see if someone else knows where it goes. We're going to go back to Austin now and ask him if he knows where this goes. Hey, Austin. Do you know where this goes? Aisle 9?
Yeah.
Here. Like that. Can you come show us where it goes? We'll see if he passes the test. Aisle 9, you say?
Aisle 9.
Are you seeing it?
Oh, you
said aisle 9. You're wrong. We brought you all the way over from the produce room, and you got it right, of course. I said, you know your grocery store business.
Straight from Long Beach, it comes back to you, you're gonna get what you deserve. Try and test out.